So, it's been a couple days. I've had some time to kind of think and just kind of simmer for a bit about all the Halo stuff that's been happening this week. And I just had some stuff I wanted to say. So, first, I guess let's talk about Halo Infinite, and then we can move on to the MCC stuff. So, Halo Infinite, that sure was a reveal. Don't think the reveal itself was handled very well. I think the things they showed in it were actually mostly okay. Obviously, I would prefer things like, no sprint, no clamber, that, the classic style gameplay. But for the most part, the actual things shown off in the reveal were pretty inoffensive. I am glad that they seem to be taking appropriate steps to kind of, classify the gameplay at least slightly. We did see the classic zoom in, for example. So no like ADSing, just the classic zoom in from the first four games in Reach. I don't know why they gave every gun ADS in Halo 5. That was really weird. But regardless, they showed things like that that kind of makes me think that at least from what they've shown, the game is going to be going back more towards more of a classic style of gameplay. But some other stuff that's been coming out, man. Like, I'm willing to give Halo Infinite the benefit of the doubt. I've been thinking about it a lot, talking about it a lot. I don't think the game is gonna be awful. At least from what they've shown, it definitely looks like it's gonna be more playable and more enjoyable than Halo 5. So I'm already on board. I'm just cautiously optimistic, if that makes sense. I want to see a lot more before I can really definitively say either way. And it looks like we're not getting a beta, so who knows what and when we'll see anything new. But essentially, my thoughts on Halo Infinite are that, hey, I'm still excited. I haven't written this game off completely yet. But there are some things that they've been talking about that have me a little worried. So first things first, Halo Infinite's multiplayer is free to play. At first, when they announced this, I thought they were just like, oh, like a free-to-play mode. Like, hey, are they doing like a battle royale separate free-to-play? That's kind of interesting. But no, they clarified just the whole multiplayer suite for Halo Infinite is going to be free-to-play. Now, first of all, let me say one thing. That's awesome. That's really, really cool. You don't need even Game Pass or Xbox Live or anything. You don't need anything. You can just play Halo Infinite multiplayer and you're good. Don't quote me on the Xbox Live part. The details on that are a little iffy, but we'll see what Microsoft has to say about that soon. Halo Infinite multiplayer free to play. Awesome. However, the reason that worries me is because of how heavily monetized Halo 5 was. Halo 5 was a $60 game with no zero leveling and customization, like none of that. It was all loot boxes. There was no unlocks. There was nothing. You bought loot boxes, and that was the only way you got anything for your characters. You want that new fancy gun to use in Warzone? Loot box. You want a new helmet? Loot box. You want a new skin for your gun or your armor? Loot box. Now, I'm fine with cosmetic purchases in games as just a general rule. Halo is a little bit different, though. Halo has a long line of games that all have amazing customization, except for Halo 5. Halo 5's customization is ass, but they all have amazing customization and huge unlocks, or excuse me, huge amounts of unlocks that you level up. You have like a set path of unlocks you go through, either in Reach with your credits and your leveling system, Halo 3 with the achievement-based unlocks. Halo 4 even had like a mix of both. Halo 4's unlocks was actually like really good, so it's weird to see them mess up so hard in 5, but Halo, part of the point of Halo is going through, unlocking new armor and showing off, like, yes, I did this. I played for X amount of hours. I did this achievement. I did that and this and that, and I got this cool armor set to show off. So Halo 5 took that out. That needs to be in the game. I don't want Halo Infinite to launch, and the only way to get any cosmetic piece is through microtransactions. That would be literal. Not that would be not that would be not good. I'm not gonna say the word I was gonna say, but that would be not great. I would be very upset to see that. So I hope they don't take that route if they're gonna monetize anything. Like, I'm okay with weapon skins or like how if Halo 5 has like the armor like patterns, like the color patterns. I'm okay with that. Like little things like that, but Halo customization is important to so many people, and I don't want to see that locked behind a paywall at all. Like, no paywall whatsoever. I want that to be in-game unlocks. Because that's all there is to unlocking Halo. It's not like Call of Duty, where you're unlocking attachments and weapons and things like that. That's not what this is. So I don't want to see any microtransactions surrounding character unlocks and equipment and things of that nature. I mean, Halo 5 was a $60 game, and it still had all these things, plus a pay-to-win multiplayer, plus, you know, like, all these extra packs and things like that, like customization packs and voiceover packs. I mean, voiceover packs are one thing, but I don't want to see loot boxes, I don't want to see cosmetic microtransactions for armor, just none of that, please. And you know, obviously free-to-play is great, but just the way you handle it is really important. Now, the other thing that has me a little weirded out is that they have confirmed the game will not have a Magnum nor a classic shotgun. The Sidekick, like 10mm handgun they showed off, really generic, weird looking one, looks like it came out of Destiny. That's the only pistol in the game. At least, excuse me, the only UNSC pistol in the game. That's weird, right? Am I the only one who thinks that's weird? Like, everyone compares it to the Halo 2 pistol, but here's a picture of the Halo 2 Magnum. As you can see, Halo 2 Magnum still looks pretty unique. I mean, it's definitely not, it was definitely stripped down, you know, and it wasn't the same as the classic Halo 1 pistol, but it's still got the front guard, it's still got, like, the things that make it a Halo pistol, whereas the Halo Infinite Sidekick just looks like a SIG. So that has me a little concerned, to say the least, but that is nothing compared to the loss of the shotgun. So the Bulldog, it already does less damage, apparently, like, just from the gameplay reveal, it looks like a faster firing, lower damage, like semi-auto almost shotgun. Cool. But why get rid of the classic stuff? 343, or at least the developer working at 343, has stated that, like, hey, the guns are not in the game, but they could still return later, which, again, has me worried. Like, I don't want this to be another Halo 5 situation where the game launches missing tons of content, and then they have to just add it in later. I mean, Halo 5 launched without Forge. Halo 5 launched without a bunch of things. They remodeled, you know, a few of these classic guns and made them look terrible. I mean, you've all seen the Halo 5 rocket launcher. That was terrible. 343 had to apologize and then add the spanker back into the game because of the backlash they got to it. Halo's look is more than just its art style. The designs of the weapons are important too. I know people are gonna say you're exaggerating and who gives a shit. Well, I give a shit. The Halo community as a whole gives a shit. And when you're trying to appease the Halo community by saying, hey, look, we're going back to the classic art style where we're really wanting to make you guys happy because we want the game to look like Halo, only then to take out two of the most, like, iconic Halo-looking weapons, that does not make any sense whatsoever. And I know the reason they're doing this is because they're going to have a big update, you know, 6 months in, being like, hey, look, you guys asked for the Magnum, and it's here. Wow, look how great we are. We're listening to the community. Have a Magnum. You know, they did that with Halo 5, too, though. They added the classic Halo 1 Magnum into the game, at least for Warzone and certain custom games, but they added it into the game as kind of like a, hey, look, like, cool new feature, have a classic gun, have a classic Halo 2 battle rifle, even though it performed the exact same as the regular battle rifle, but whatever. Things like that. I know that's what they're trying to pull again, and I just, these little things that we're seeing has me worried for where the direction of this game could be going. Obviously, it's way too early to know, but knowing 343 and knowing Microsoft and how they monetize their games, yeah, this could get bad real quick. So, that's pretty much it for Halo Infinite. I'm still excited, but again, I'm cautiously optimistic. I am definitely wanting to see a lot more, and the more I'm seeing has me worried. So, that's Halo Infinite. However, that is not the end of our discussion here, because a lot has happened with MCC. Yay, something good. So, Master Chief Collection has been updating itself throughout this year. This year, if nothing else, will be known as the Year of Halo. Totally. That nothing else is happening this year, it's just Halo. That's all that matters. So, Halo 3 just came out on PC, and they're getting ready to bring in ODST into the collection. With that comes Firefight to the Xbox, since that was missing from the original collection, and then, of course, Campaign and Firefight for PC users. But looks like at the same time, they are also planning on updating Halo 3 with ODST weapons. So they showed off a screenshot. Screenshot of this Spartan here. First of all, that is a weapon skin that you see right there. But here he's holding the Halo 3 ODST pistol, which is not the same as the Halo 3 pistol, Magnum, I assure you. It's significantly better. They're adding this into the game. Right behind there, you see a blue plasma rifle. If I scroll down even, this Spartan here is holding an ODST, a silenced SMG. And they said they're doing the same with ODST as well. If we look right here at this Firefight menu, it's kind of hard to see. Can I zoom this in? The starting weapon is the Battle Rifle. Battle Rifle was not in ODST, so they are confirming they're bringing these weapons cross games with ODST and Halo 3. And of course, cosmetics in a Halo 3 as well. They did this already with Halo CE. Came out of literal nowhere, but it looks like they're doing it again with Halo 3. So we'll see what amount of Halo 3 content comes. I do like that skin. I can't tell. Is that for the sniper rifle? It's a little difficult to tell just from it being on his back. But whatever it is, it's a cool looking skin. So hopefully they can do, you know, some pretty unique customizations like they did with CE. And hopefully, of course, there's the toggle to turn that off, because I know some people want to stay classic Halo experience, no weird colors and things like that, which I totally understand. CE does give you the option to turn that off, which is great. I guess we'll see how they handle it there. They did also confirm matchmaking for ODST Firefight, which is great. They are going to be starting flighting this month. And then, of course, features planned for this year. So this is kind of the big thing. We've been talking about crossplay in MCC for ages now. They did confirm crossplay is planned to launch this year. Says crossplay, input-based matchmaking, and server region selections are planned to release together. They're also planning to release the custom game browser. Finally, they've been talking about this for years. Custom game browser, per-game graphics options, and mouse and keyboard support for the Xbox, all kind of at the same time. They're also looking into, of course, you know, planning on releasing this year the PC file share, double keybinds, view model adjustments for all the games. Right now, you can only do it in Reach, and Steam account linking, which is great. They did confirm that they are officially looking into improving the uncapped frame rate support for Halo 2 Anniversary and Halo Reach. As of right now, if you try to play it higher than 60 FPS in Halo 2 Anniversary Multiplayer and Halo Reach, you'll get some serious just bugs and unplayable messes. Not sure why it does that, but it's something about that higher refresh rate support doesn't work properly. You have to cap your game to 60 FPS when you play Reach or Halo 2 Anniversary, or else it just feels really wrong. If you guys watched the stream when I first, when Halo Anniversary, or excuse me, Halo Reach first came out, I was complaining every 5 seconds about how it felt like shit, and I didn't know why, but this is why. The game does not properly support higher than 60 FPS. Halo 1, 2, and 3 do, but not 2 Anniversary Multiplayer or Reach. Here's hoping that ODST and 4 don't have that problem, but as of right now, they're looking into Reach and Halo 2 Anniversary to try to fix that. They're also looking at achievement issues. There's been a lot of weird achievement issues that I've been having, and many of my other friends have been having as well. And UI improvements. The UI in MCC is a mess, so they're looking to kind of streamline that, improving navigation specifically, the roster, customization, and many more areas of the game. So this is great. It looks like they at least have the major things that the people have been asking for are on the docket. Things they're currently discussing right now, or excuse me, in the backlog, really. They're talking about text chat on and off option, which would be great. Text chat's super weird and like it's huge on your screen. Idle system improvements. If you are away from your PC for more than 2 seconds, you're considered idle. It's fucking stupid. PC features to console, so like FOV sliders and stuff like that. I know the console players have been wanting that for a while, and the new consoles should be able to handle that no problem. I don't know if there'd be any issues with a Halo 2 anniversary and Halo CE anniversary. Might be a little bit too demanding there, but at least for Halo 1, 2, 3, Reach, and ODST, there should be no issue, and 4, there should be no issues with having an FOV slider on console. Split screen on PC, which would be great. There is an achievement on PC that you need split screen for that you cannot unlock unless you have played the Xbox version. I got that achievement on Xbox, so I have it unlocked on my Steam account and, of course, on Xbox Live, but some players literally cannot get that achievement, and it's... I don't know what to say, man. They should have taken out a Steam version or something, but... and HDR support, which is very nice as well. So MCC, all promising additions. Everything they're talking about with MCC, looks like the game is finally coming together, which is great after so long of it being not a video game. So I'm happy with where MCC is headed, worried about where Halo Infinite is headed, and that's pretty much the state of Halo in 2020. I haven't been talking about it because I just wanted to kind of take everything in, think about it for a bit, and come at you once I've kind of decided, or come at you with the full information once I've kind of learned more about it. But MCC seems to be doing well. Crossplay is going to help this game a ton. The custom games browser is going to be a lifesaver, PC file share. Like those are the three most important things we need right now. Custom games browser, crossplay, and a PC file share. Because right now, getting into custom games is super difficult because you need people who already have these things, already have these game modes, or have made it again. You need to know these people already. It's not like Halo 3 or Reach where you can just go search in like the top menus, like, oh, this is popular right now, this is what people are playing. Custom games browser will fix that, because first of all, you'll be able to just search for a full list of all the custom games people are playing. PC file share will help as well, because then you can easily share things, and then crossplay will even more greatly affect this, because then you can actually matchmake with a whole extra platform, which has, you know, a number of more players, which is going to help matchmaking times. It's going to help, you know, matchmaking in general. More players means more people closer together, which means smoother connections. It's going to help crossplay. It's going to help custom games. More people available for those custom games. Just generally going to keep this game alive far longer than it normally would have. Same goes for Infinite. I know they've already said Infinite's going to have crossplay, but that is a good thing. The game needs crossplay. Crossplay is the future. So games, if you're coming out, add crossplay, please. Do it. That's pretty much it for me. I just want to talk about Halo for a bit and gush and worry, and that's pretty much it. So, wow, I recorded for 18 minutes straight, no cuts. Let's see how terrible this is on playback. But I'll see you guys the next one. Let me know what you guys think. Are you worried about Infinite? Are you excited? What about MCC on PC or console? You're going to have an influx of players sometime this year, so that'll be nice. Let me know what you guys think down below, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Stay classy.